Never give up. Why we talk about this? This is something which is related to each and every aspect that what we expect in our life is related to. Reason being what? I'll tell you about this fact. The reason being from my own perspective is because I became an aviator. I became a pilot. So I know what were the hurdles on the way and how I tackled it. So guys, please watch this video till the end, do like and subscribe, and please tell me what your opinion, if you think in a different way or there might be something which I think so I should add on to further, you know, practical for myself in my life and for the benefit of others. So guys, let's start. When we say that never give up, why we say that? Because in your life to achieve your dream, there will be so many hurdles in your life that to achieve that you have to, you know, you have to give your 110%. It's not 100%. I'm telling you, you have to give your 110%. Reason being is there are so many things, there are so many difficulties, there are so many phases in our life which will pull you back. मैं आपको एक नॉर्मल सी चीज बताता हूँ. स्टार्टिंग यू नो फ्रॉम, अगर आपको जैसे अगर आप बोलें कि आपको पायलट बनना है, आई बिकेम एन एविएटर, आई बिकेम अ पायलट, तो उसके लिए मैंने भी बहुत मेहनत की है. मेरे को पता नहीं था कि मतलब शायद इतनी मुश्किलें आएंगी. जनरली लगता था कि थिंग्स आर यू नो वेरी इजी, व्हाट इज देयर, जस्ट टू फ्लाई एन एयरक्राफ्ट, इट विल बी यू नो जस्ट अ पीस ऑफ केक. बट गाइज नो, इट्स नॉट दैट. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सबसे पहले हम एग्जाम की बात करते हैं. एग्जाम से पहले चीज क्या आती है? द नॉलेज फॉर दैट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू हैव नॉलेज, यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू हैव टू स्टडी एंड हाउ यू हैव टू स्टडी. फॉर दैट योर डिटर्मिनेशन, योर फोकस एंड योर कंसेंट्रेशन कम्स इनटू एक्ट. एंड वंस यू डू दैट, एवरीथिंग इज कंबाइंड, देन यू कैन क्लियर योर एग्जाम एंड फर्दर यू रीच फॉर योर SSB. नाउ SSB एवरीबडी नोज इट्स अ बिग प्रोसेस एंड सो मेनी गाइज अपीयर. And how many do pass? Peanuts. So guys, you can understand, जब हम बात करते हैं ऐसी चीजों के लिए, ऐसी चीजों के बारे में, कितने लोग उस चीज को क्लियर करते हैं. हम IAS, IPS सब इस चीज की बात करते हैं, लेकिन अगर हम SSB का भी रेशियो उठा के देखेंगे तो इट विल बी समवेयर देयर. ओके, सो इट्स नॉट दैट इजी. फॉर दैट मेनी गाइज अपियर फॉर SSB, दे डोंट क्लियर. बट डू दे गिव अप? नो. लाइव एग्जाम्पल इज myself. Guys, I gave SSB 4 times. Imagine 4 times. And as I've heard from lot many people, they have given SSB 5 times, 7 times, 8 times, 10 times. You know, that's pretty huge amount if somebody can, you know, focus on that fact. But the fact is, once they don't clear it after 2 or 3 attempts, they feel like, you know, there is nothing to work upon. It is something like, you know, it is naturally in myself. Something will come up, the day I'll go, I'll give my best and maybe I'll clear it. It's not that, guys. For that, you have to work hard. You need to keep your focus. You need to concentrate and you need to understand your surroundings. You need to understand the situation. You need to assess the things where you are going wrong. I tried myself. Once I failed once or twice. Every time I reach, till conference round and I was out in conference round, I thought, what's wrong with me? Why am I not able to do it? In my 3rd time, I was able to clear my technical entry. But I wanted to go for flying. But I didn't give up. See, I still got a job outside. I got a job in MNC. But I didn't give up. Because that was my dream, guys. For dream, you have to run behind it. For your dream, you have to work hard. For your dream, you have to focus. You have to leave everything aside and just concentrate and focus. And think all the possible ways that you can put into it and achieve your dream. After 4 times, I cleared. Then I went for, you know, academy for training. So guys, training is also not that easy. People do think, okay, I'll go there, I'll do it. If I'm good in studies, I might be able to do that. But guys, it's lot mental. You know, there's lot of mental pressure. You have to work hard. You have to study. You have to do other activities also. And with that, you have to perform. And you have to understand things. You have to put yourself into that situation for which you are practicing. So guys, something we called about chair flying. So, you know, I heard from a lot of many people, they say that chair flying, you know, just sit on chair and practice. No guys, it's not that. You put yourself into that situation. You put yourself in that cockpit and then you practice. Because at that point of time, you try and, simulate situations wherein you do mistakes. Once you do mistakes, then you learn from your mistakes. Okay, here I was going wrong. Okay, here I think I'm pretty confident with this thing, but still I'm not able to do. जब हम एक्चुअल सिचुएशन में जाते हैं, बिकॉज दिस इज स्टिल कंफर्टेबल, क्योंकि हम एक चेयर फ्लाइंग की बात करें, आई एम सिटिंग इन अ कंफर्टेबल एनवायरनमेंट, आई एम जस्ट थिंकिंग अबाउट दोस फैक्ट्स, आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग इट. बट डू इट you know, anybody, do they think that it's that simple? No, guys, it's not. For that, you have to work hard. You need to have focus. You need to think about situations. You have to assess yourself. If you put yourself in some situation and, you know, get out of that comfort zone and try and assess yourself, then you see where do you stand. Never give up comes in this also, because many guys get out of their flying because they are not able to perform. And thing is, just it's the mental pressure which is taking them out. They are not able to focus more. They are not able to, you know, go ahead with that situation, with that mental pressure. They are not able to handle it. So you don't give up at any point of time, because if you will not give up, you will achieve your dream. I failed in my exams. So I was like, you know, yeah, what happened? I was preparing so hard. I was doing everything, whatever, you know, other persons were doing, you know, other coursemates were doing. But I realized that I might be lacking at some of the places where I think that I'm perfect, but I was not. So guys, these are, you know, some of the facts which we don't take into account, and we just think that everybody is doing it, I will also be able to do it. But guys, every person is different. He has got its own capabilities. He has got its own mental thinking, its own processes. So other person can do it, but you lack there. So you need to understand that. After that, it's not just that. You have to practice for your sorties. You have to practice for your maneuvers. You have to practice for different kind of missions. And with that, your physical studies and everything which is going on simultaneously. You do that, you come to the other side. For that, you have, you know, focus. For that, you need to have that attitude, that never give up. After you get commissioned, after you get your wings, guys, that journey is not over. Because let me tell you frankly, flying is a thing, and especially from talking about defense forces, the reason being is they are not doing a route to route flying, or, you know, just a fancy flying. Guys, there are missions, there are so many things which are involved, and which will, you know, that's the thing which makes you different from normal flying. Because here you are flying aircrafts of different types. You categorize yourself, you upgrade yourself, you move to different aircraft, because all aircrafts have different characteristics. So you need to understand them. You have to adapt. You have to put yourself in other situations wherein, you know, you can come up with a different idea and you can, you know, develop something new. And everybody is ready to accept once you show them, okay, this thing is possible. For that, what you have to do? For that, you have to learn to adapt to situations. For that, you have to put yourself in those shoes and you have to try and assess the situation, because every mission is different. You are practicing for any mission, there are so many things which can go wrong. But many times what happens, if we are not able to do it, sometimes we think, yeah, I cannot do this, yeah, I can do only this much. Guys, that's not the attitude. If you will think it in that way, you will not be, you know, able to progress ahead in your career, and that will come to a full stop. So guys, that full stop should never be there. With that, you continuously evolve, you continuously develop yourself, continuously you read, you make situations, you come to a particular situation wherein you think, okay, here this thing is not possible, if me or my group or my team, we can put in something extra and we can achieve that. So for that, you are always welcome. You can give your ideas. And guys, for this, I should say that whenever you think anything is possible, maybe you should try it out and give it a thought and then convey it to others, so that when the situation comes, they let you in that situation and let you assess it, let you go ahead with that situation. So once you do it, you achieve it. And what to say about that? That means you have success the way you wanted it to be, not just by luck or something, you know, which goes in a normal day-to-day routine life. So these are the things which defines you and which makes you different from other people. You stand apart in crowd, guys. You have that attitude. You become a better person. You become a man. Okay, you become a man for which other persons look at you. You become a role model for so many people, you know, for your own family, for your kids, for your friends, or maybe for your juniors, because they look at you. They know that this is the guy here we can bank upon. This is the guy who will help us out, because he thinks in a different way. He has, you know, ways and means of doing things in his own way. But they all are right. He is not going wrong anywhere. He is not breaking any rules. Because if you are breaking rules, guys, then you are risking everything in your life. risk in a particular situation is okay, but that has to be a calculated risk. Like, you know, generally we say there's a very thin line between confidence and overconfidence. So here also, there's a very thin line, you know, of taking risk, which will help you to achieve something or which might lead to some disaster. So guys, nobody wants that. Okay. So you have to keep this thing in mind that if you want to achieve this, then you have to draw that line and you have to be on the safer side. You try and implement different things. If you are able to do it, very well. But if you are not able to do it, don't just give up and say like, you know, I couldn't do it, so it was not in this way. But try it in a different way. Some things which are there, which we have to understand, they are not possible. If I will say that I want to fly my aircraft and I want to go at a speed of 4 max, that is not possible. Because I know my aircraft is not meant to do that. So you have to look at the situations wherein the situation is possible. Don't go for some hypothetical situation which is not possible. So for that, once you are applying your ideas and you have that attitude, you know, I will try and do it. Do it. Try it. Maybe what? You will get success or, you know, the worst part. Maybe you not. But if we are not able to do it, then we know, because this way is not possible. So at least you are satisfied with yourself that you know, because I knew that right now that this thing is not possible. But that is not a failure. That is also an achievement, because you know what I wanted to do and however I wanted to do, I tried it and it didn't work out. So guys, I will, you know, from my perspective, from my thought process, the way I have seen the life and, you know, the way I have gone through my training and everything and, you know, all the situations what I have faced. The only thing I would say is never give up, because if this thought will come to your mind about giving up at any point of time, that will, you know, your life will come to a full stop at that point and your dream will shatter. And if you want to live your dream, so guys, for that you need to have that attitude, that never give up. Try, give it your best and see where the situation takes you. It might take you, you know, you might succeed or you might not. If you might not, then also it will give you a satisfaction that I at least tried and now I know that this situation is not possible. So guys, that's it from my side, and I tried a lot, because so many SSB aspirants who come to me and talk about these facts, then I have to tell them that, you know, failure is also a part of life, but you have to take it in a positive way. You have to understand that if I'm going wrong and if I'm not succeeding, that I need to assess the situations, where am I going wrong? And for that, see, you still, if you go right, you might not be able to make it, say, I would say that, like, you know, you take the medicals, you might be in, just God forbid, I would say, but there might be a situation where you will not be able to clear your medicals, but that is just too bad. You cannot do anything about it, because that is something natural, the way God has made us. But you did put all your efforts that were required and you had that attitude of never giving up, which at least took you there. And I told you, like, you know, success and failure. Now for that failure also, you know, where do you stand? And things went wrong. It's just not your mistake. It's just something natural about which we cannot do anything. So guys, that's it from my side. I hope you must have gotten my point that in your life, for your dreams, you should never give up. Always keep trying hard and go for it, and you will succeed in your life and you will achieve your dream. So guys, that's it from my side. Take care. Bye-bye and Jai Hind.